last year. Was she allowed to eat the fruits and roots and shoots of the forest, but he loved something else even more. He loved vegetables in farmer's garden. One day, Monsieur went to the edge of the forest. He looked at row after row of vegetables. He said, "Choose a cucumbers, yummy yums." And he started into the garden. Slow, 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 and snap! Oh, his leg was caught in a snare. Monsieur just pulled, and he pulled, but he couldn't run, get away. "Oh no," he said. "Monsieur will help me for dinner." Then he saw a farmer coming. Monsieur talked fast. He lay on the ground and made his body stiff. "Well, well, well," said farmer. "Look, look what I caught. Monsieur? But he looks dead." Most farmer pushed him with his foot, but Monsieur didn't move. "Maybe has been dead a long time. Too bad. I guess we can't to eat him." Then he pulled Monsieur's leg out of the snare. Then he tossed Monsieur back into the forest. Monsieur landed with a soft thud. Then he jumped up and ran behind him. He heard from a yell, "Hey, hey, you tricked me!" Monsieur just laughed. "Ha, ha, farmer, you are smart, but I is smarter." A few days passed. Monsieur just kept thinking about all those vegetables. One day, he went back to the edge of the forest. Said Monsieur, "Tasty carrots, scrumptious sweet potatoes." Then he saw something new. It looks like a man, but his head and his body was a rubber. "A scarecrow! That silly farmer! Does he think he can scare me with that? Oh, I will show him how scared I am," said Monsieur. Then Monsieur marched up to the scarecrow. "Take this!" He gave it a big kick, but his leg was stuck to the scarecrow. "Let me go," said Monsieur. He pulled and he pulled, then he pushed with his other front leg. But they stuck too. "Turn me loose." He pulled and he pulled, then he pushed with his two back legs. But they stuck too. "Turn put me down." He pulled and he pushed and he pulled and he pushed, but Monsieur just dropped. Then he saw a farmer coming. Monsieur talked fast, but he didn't have any ideas. "Well, well, well," said farmer. "How nice of you to come back, Monsieur." He pulled Monsieur off the scarecrow and carried him to the house. He put him outside in an empty chamber. "I will keep you here tonight, and tomorrow you will be our dinner." All that night, Monsieur just lay there sadly. Then he heard something. "Why, it's Monsieur. So farmer call you at last? It serves you right." "It was farmer's dog. Monsieur talk fast." "Why do you mean dog? Mon, the farmer catch me." "Then why are you in the pool?" said the dog. "Because there are not enough bed in the house. You see, farmer is holding a feast tomorrow and I'm the guest of honor," said Monsieur. "The guest of honor? It's not fair. I have been his loyal friend for years. And you were just a thief. The guest of honor is said most of you. Really? You don't mind? Not at all, though. You deserve it, said most of you. Most of you are not sweet bad after all. Thank you. Then dog lifted the latch and opened the door. Welcome, dog. Enjoy the feast, said Moustier, who still ran for the forest. Then he watched from the forest edge. He saw Farmer come out and stared at dog. You stupid dog! You stupid! You let the Moustier get away! Moustier just laughed. Ha ha ha! Farmer will have me to find a different dinner now, said Moustier. Then he wound up singing his song. I'm quick and smart as can be, try and try, but you can get me. Moustier is the smart, clever animal in the forest. But he knew many big animals want to eat him as lunch. But they had first catch Moustier. One day, Moustier walked through of the forest, but in the forest he heard something. Roar! It was Tiger. Hello, Tiger. What do you doing here? Moustier just asked to the tiger. Hello, Moustier. I was just getting hungry, and now you can be my lunch. Moustier didn't want to be a lunch. He looked around at the forest, talked fast, and he saw a mud of puddle. I'm sorry, Tiger. I can't. You're lunch. I can be your lunch, said Moustier. The king has ordered me to guard off his pudding. His pudding? Said Tiger. Yes, there it is. Moustier pointed to the mud of puddle. Here, the mud of puddle. It has the best taste in the world. The king doesn't want anyone to taste it. The tiger wants to taste the king's pudding, but Moustier just said, "Oh no, Tiger, no! The king would be very angry. Just one little taste, Moustier. The king will never know," said Tiger. Well, alright, Tiger. Maybe you can taste a little, but first, let me run away so no one will blame you. Alright, Moustier, you can go away, said Tiger. So Moustier ran away and left the tiger with the pudding. Imagine, said Tiger, the king's pudding. He took with a big mouth. Pooh! He spit it out. That yuck! It's not pudding, it's mud, said Tiger. Oh, wait, Moustier, you trick me. Wait, I will find you and I will eat you, said Tiger. Tiger ran through the forest. Roar! He called out with Moustier. Moustier, you trick me! But no, you will be my lunch, said Tiger. Moustier looked around and talked fast. He saw a wasp's nest in a tree. I'm sorry, Tiger. I can be your lunch. The king has ordered me to guard his throne.
said the moisture.
He's strong?
Yes, there it is.
Moisture pointed to the roughness. The roughness. It has the best sound in the world. The king doesn't want anyone to hit them.
Tiger said, I would like to hit the drums, king.
Oh no, Tiger. The king would be very, very angry.
Just one little hit, Moisture, the king will never know.
Well, alright. But first, let me run away so no one will blame me.
Alright, you can go away, Moisture.
Moisture ran quickly to the forest edge.
Imagine, said Tiger, the king's drum. He reached up and hit it.
Pooh!
The wolves all flame up.
They start to sting Tiger.
Ouch! Oh, no! Itch! That's not drum. That's a wolf's nest.
Tiger ran away, but the wolves only follow him.
Bzzz. Ouch! No!
Tiger came to the stream. He jumped in his flags and stayed underwater as long as he could. At least wolves went away.
Moisture! You tricked me once, you tricked me twice, but now you will be my lunch, said Tiger.
Moisture looked around and took fast.
He saw a cobra. The giant snake was coiled asleep on the ground.
I'm sorry, Tiger, I can be your lunch. The king has ordered to guard his bell.
His bell? Said Tiger.
Yes, there it is. Moisture pointed to the cobra.
It's the best bell in the world. The king doesn't want anyone else to wear it.
Tiger said, I would like to wear the king's bell.
Oh no, Tiger. The king will be very, very angry, said Moisture.
Just for one moment,
Moisture, the king will never know, said Tiger.
Well, alright, Tiger, but first let me run away so no one will blame me.
Alright, Moisture, now you can run away, said Tiger.
Moisture ran quickly, out of sight.
Imagine, said Tiger, the king's bell.
He started to run it around himself.
The cobra woke up.
It didn't wait for Tiger to finish wrapping. It wrapped itself around Tiger. Then it squeezed him and bit him.
Oh, no! Wait! Wait, no! Oh, that's no bell. That's a cobra. Help me! Moisture, help!
Moisture was far away, and as he warned, he was safe.
Thank you. So this is my story, and thank you for watching. Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.